Something completely different.
Something completely different, which is extremely radical. Yes, it's Scientific Sue's Wonder Lab. Let's see what she's up to today.
Welcome, 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 one and all, back to Scientific Sue's Wonder Lab. We are a bunch of busy beavers today. Let me tell you, we got the lab coats on, we got the clay out, we got the goggles on, safety first. But what are we making? I'll tell you what we're making today. We are making exploding volcanoes.
We're going to explode them.
I'm going to use your cocktail stick to push all of that powder down into your volcano. And what I want you to do is just to put a squirt of food colouring into yours. Great, great. Now, you each have a bottle which has got vinegar in. So take the lid off. And you've also got your own pipette. So using your pipette, you're going to go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then I'm going to all squirt. 5, 4, 3.
Volcanoes made from?
We've got inside the earth, we've got, it's so hot, the rock actually melts. And because of then it becomes a liquid, it's lighter, so it floats up, it's less dense. But usually, see the way we've got a hole here? Usually we don't have a hole. The pressure builds up and the pressure builds up until all of the magma explodes skywards. Should we do one where we can kind of maybe get an explosion that goes skywards?
Yes!
Does this look like a volcano?
No.
But it is going to become a volcano. So what we're going to do is put inside some washing up liquid. So the washing up liquid is going to trap all of the carbon dioxide gas that we make. Then we're going to put in, what was this acid?
Vinegar.
So pour in some vinegar. Now, what is the powder we have to add?
Baking soda.
Okay, are we ready?
Yeah!
You sure?
Yeah!
Let's go! You ready for this?
Yeah!
Drop yours in quickly. One detonator, two detonators, three detonators. On with the lid really quickly. This is so dangerous. I'm gonna give it to you! Shake it and stop! Stop! And the pressure's building up. And the pressure's building up. And the pressure's building up. And the
I like your man bowing at the end as well. That was very nice.
Lovely.
Very explosive, the old volcanoes, eh?
Explosive volcanoes.
What do they like, volcanoes? What do you like, volcanoes?
You know, they build up a lot of pressure, and then they just explode! Like, you're going to explode tonight when you get in the ring with Rockstar.
Oh, it's going to be explosive entertainment, I'll tell you that.
It's going to be explosive. But now, more on that later. Our next guest is an American journalist who decided to enter the American Memory Championships. Yes, that's right. They have a championships for memory, for remembering things. Imagine that.
Oh, I forgot about that.
Well, yes, he entered the Memory Championships, and after only 1 year of training, he won the U.S. Memory Championships. It's an incredible story. He's an incredible guy. It's Josh Forward.
Josh, thanks for tuning in with us. You are a master of memory. In the space of a single year, you trained your memory to be able to win the American Memory Championships. How did you do that?
Well, you know, it turns out there are all of these ancient techniques that people used to all know about and which most of us today have kind of forgotten about. And if you use those techniques, you can actually remember a whole lot more information than you would have thought possible.
And is it possible for anybody to improve their memory to such a high extent?
You know, that was the question that I had, and it turns out anybody can improve their memory using these ancient memory techniques.
Wow, so myself, yourself, maybe even